Welcome to the course Mastering Big Data Analytics with PySpark. My name is Danny Meijer and I will be your course instructor throughout the course. I'm a lead data engineer in the Netherlands at a leading sport retailer. I have over 13 years of experience in IT and I've been working in the big data field for a good number of years now. I have extensive experience with large-scale analytics and cloud solutions. I'm fluent in Hadoop, Spark, SQL, and various NoSQL languages. I'm also a self-proclaimed Python guru. So let me show you what's all in the course. The course has a total of 9 sections in which I aim to take you on a journey from head to toe through the amazing world of PySpark. Let me break these sections down. Section 1, Python and Spark, a match made in heaven. In this section, we will be getting ourselves ready for the rest of the course. We will explore the intricate relationship between Python and Spark. We will be setting up for the course by downloading the example datasets and the rest of the course material, and you get to run your very first Spark code. By the end of this section, you will be all set up for the future videos in this course. In section 2, working with PySpark, we will be covering some important theory and background on Spark. We will be getting to know Spark, to familiarize ourselves with Spark, where it came from, what it is, and its syntax. We will be zooming in on the distributed nature of Spark and the machine learning library. We will learn about the various Spark modules and libraries, and we will learn about how Spark handles data with data frames, data operations, and lineage graphs. In section 3, preparing data using Spark SQL, we are going to put our skills to use and go on a journey through the Spark SQL module in a very hands-on manner. We will start by covering the basics, learning how to load data and how to explore it. Then we will be cleansing our data using a range of techniques that Spark SQL hands us. We will round off on the topic of grouping, joining, and aggregating our datasets. Section 4, Machine Learning with Spark MLlib. In this section, we will start a deep dive into Spark's machine learning library. We will be getting to know Spark's MLlib component and getting hands-on with machine learning with Spark. We will do this by building a recommender system for movies. While building our recommender system, we will get to really know how Spark MLlib works internally with the goal to familiarize ourselves with Spark syntax. You will get to build, train, and tune your very first machine learning model using native Spark machine learning libraries. In the next section, section 5, classification and regression, we will continue our deep dive into Apache Spark's machine learning library that we started in the previous section, with the accompanying examples focusing on classification and regression. We will start with exploring some of the lesser knowns and less well-documented parts of Spark MLlib. We will explore data sources and data types specific to the machine learning library. We'll get to explore how Spark ML handles vectors and sample data. And you will learn about model persistence, allowing for models to be saved and loaded for pre-computation and reuse. You will learn about assembling and using machine learning pipelines. And we will also zoom in much deeper into machine learning library, including all the documents and examples that it ships with. By the end of this section, you should be able to find your way through the extensive Spark ML library and know how to approach implementing a use case of your own using Spark's machine learning library. Next, we will be setting up for another hands-on use case. Over the course of several sections, we will be building a streaming sentiment analysis solution using natural language processing and Spark Streaming. We start this journey in section 6, analyzing big data. Here, we will be setting up and preparing for our use case, focusing on data exploration and data acquisition. We will learn how Spark handles natural language processing and how we are going to handle sentiment analysis with Spark. We focus on data identification and data acquisition and start collecting the data that we need to train a sentiment analysis model on. You will learn additional tips and tricks on how the Spark Lab environment can be effectively used for exploring a dataset, focusing heavily on the interaction between pandas and PySpark. We will also get to visualize some data statistics using CMOR. By the end of this section, we will have a thorough understanding of how Spark interacts with pandas and how you can approach data exploration and data acquisition with PySpark. We will have set ourselves up for the next phase in building a streaming sentiment analysis solution. Section 7, Processing Natural Language in Spark. In this section, we will continue our journey to a streaming sentiment analysis solution. We will go through the data cleaning process by taking the findings being covered from the previous section and applying Spark SQL functions and regular expressions to the data that we had prepared. Since regular expressions are an important part of natural language processing, we will also explore that topic. Once the data is cleaned, we will continue by training a sentiment analysis model. By the end of this section, you will have a thorough understanding of how to wrangle and clean data for use with a natural language application, as well as understanding how regex works in Spark. We will come out of this section with a trained model that we will have persisted to disk for use in the next one. In section 8, machine learning in real time, we will finish the journey toward building a streaming sentiment analysis solution using natural language processing and Spark Streaming. We will be exploring the Twitter API and learn how we can use it to stream tweets in real time. We will focus on understanding Spark Streaming, how it works, how to manage streams, and how to convert between static and streaming applications. Finally, we will round off this section by putting all we have learned and prepared together, and finally assemble a real-time sentiment analysis solution. In section 9, I will share with you how Spark can be run in a production setting, and not just in our lab environment. I will show what the real power of PySpark is. You will learn about submitting applications to a Spark cluster. I will talk about running Spark at scale, sharing with you vendors that can run Spark in the cloud, as well as showing various things to keep in mind while scaling up applications, such as configuration mappings. I will round off this section by sharing with you tips, tricks, and takeaways. Once you have completed all the video material for this course, you should have a good understanding about which steps to take next in your journey to mastering Spark. You should also be able to start building your own ML solutions in PySpark, and you will know your way around the extensive machine learning library. On this slide, I have shared some of the prerequisites that are necessary for you to be able to continue in this course. The hardware requirements, what I've prepared should run under any of the popular OSs, so either Windows, Mac, or Linux. You're going to need quite a powerful processor, at least a dual core, an Intel Core i5 or equivalent is recommended. When you're coming in, bring at least 2 GB of memory. If you can, bring more. 8 GB is recommended. And you're going to need some storage, at least 300 MB for the data sets that you need, but up to 2 GB is recommended. There's some software requirements. Make sure you have Python 3.6 installed, and also go and sign up and download Docker Desktop. I'm assuming that you have moderate to advanced Python programming knowledge, along with knowledge on analytics workloads or other data science related topics. Prior knowledge of Spark is not needed, but it is recommended. I'm excited to have you in this course. Let's get started.